It was a long, hot summer back in 1984, my first full summer in Hollywood, California. I'd been placing Music Connection magazine free musician, singer ads, looking to front a band with no avail. Surely I thought I'd fit in somewhere. After all, I was in Los Angeles, young, talented singer with an image. I had started writing a lot of songs and dark poetry since leaving the Midwest. By fall, I'd had enough of this stagnation and decided to run a large display ad in Music Connection magazine looking for a band to front. A band where I could sing and write songs, where I could grow and perform. Shortly after the ad ran, I got a call from Peter Kay, who'd done some work with Jay Giles' band. We got together and did some impromptu writing and recording of a song I wrote called Laying Down Tracks. It was my first pseudo-song music working experience, outside of a day with a group of musicians I jammed with. I loved singing and recording very much. We really didn't finish anything but started. For reasons unknown to me, we did not continue. He seemed to be busy with sessions and other work. Then I got a call from Mike Panera saying, "Hey, I saw your ad in Music Connection and I wanted to tell you, you don't have to do it like that." That way, meaning finding a group of musicians and jamming and hope they'd show up to rehearse and all get along enough to want to stay in a band situation at least long enough to record. I was intrigued by the new method being suggested, a demo, an EP. We talked about writing, that he was a songwriter, guitarist, and that he could possibly produce some tracks for me. Mike had a hit song in 1970 called Ride Captain Ride. Mike also played guitar with Iron Butterfly and was a touring guitarist for Alice Cooper. This was pretty exciting as I'd grown to be a pretty big Alice Cooper fan. Actually, I just a year earlier in film class, I'd used Welcome to My Nightmare as a background track to my short film project in college. So this sounded like a remarkable opportunity, plus Mike was a very friendly, warm, upbeat person with good vibes and a fantastic guitarist. I felt hopeful of where this musical endeavor may lead. We decided to meet down in the marina by the ocean. I remember how nervous I was. Was this really happening? I took my catalog of songs and poems that I'd spent the past spring and summer cataloging. Mike had read through my songs and we planned to meet for writing sessions. He suggested recording a 4 or 5 song demo. Mike said he liked my songs and uncommitted vocal style. Coming from him, it was quite a compliment. Mike picked out 5 songs to record: Heart Up, He Made Her Shiver, Blue Nun, Hidden Fortress, and Mission of Mercy from my catalog. He instilled a lot of confidence in me. He seemed like a kindred spirit, and I was grateful and I felt very blessed to be working with him. Mike decided to include me in a live show he was performing with his band at Music Machine in Santa Monica. Chris Mancini from Arista Publishing was there, and Peter came down, my first attempt at songwriting partner. Mike Panera was and always will be a very key component of all my musical days. He taught me how to write music.